My name is Christine Wijaya, and I came to Tasmania in early 2000. Every day I walk to my office, I really feel thankful to be where I am now and to be able to find a job and live here in Tasmania.
My name is Amanda French. I'm the General Manager of Dress for Success Hobart. And in 2019, we were lucky enough to get a grant from the Tas Community Fund to get things up and running. Christine was one of our very first clients, which was a real privilege to be able to work with her. She was very accommodating of us because we were just starting out too.
I originally came from Indonesia, but I've been in Australia for 4 years, and I had been looking for a job for around a year in Tasmania, and then I got a very important interview call. In here, I don't really have a support system, and I don't have someone who can give me with fashion advice.
The Dress for Success exists to empower women to support them into employment. We provide a range of different services, starting with our styling service for interview and for employment, to support women to build their confidence so that they can get a job. They book in to see us for 1 hour. Traditionally, that's the time that we spend with them. We will talk to them about their interview and give them a few tips around how to prepare for that interview. And then we go through the styling process. So we already know their size, we know their preferences, and we select a range of clothing for them to try on here in the boutique. We then take them through those clothing choices, and they then pick what they feel most comfortable in.
She showed me some sets of clothing that she had picked up for me. And at first I looked at the shirts and the pants, and I thought that I wouldn't really want to wear that. Amanda chatted with me and gave me some advice about how to get ready for the interview, and also she gave me some possible questions that the interviewer will ask, and it was really helpful. I left Dress for Success with a set of clothing for interview, and also a handbag and matching shoes. And I had never had such a beautiful set of clothing before. When I came to the interview itself, I really felt the difference, and the interview went well. And about a week or so later, I got the good news that I was successful.
So knowing that Christine didn't have that network of support around her, for a really big moment in her life, going for a new job in her new home state, it was a real privilege to be able to provide that support for her and for her family as well.
So I'm a part-time project officer. To come to the place where I am now, it's really beyond my imagination. And it's just good to be able to provide a safe and good environment for my children to grow up.
We're so lucky we've had all of these beautiful clothing pieces donated by the generous public. We have had lots of corporates that have done clothing drives for us and have donated all of those items as well. We've just been overwhelmed with the support. We literally couldn't have got started without the Tasmanian Community Fund, and to have their support for a charity that had just started was just such a boost for our confidence to know that what we were going to do was going to make a real difference in our community.
I feel that more people need to know about Dress for Success, because I know out there are many people who really need the services and help that Amanda and Dress for Success can provide.